here. I don't need any space here. So. This is, now there's, I do this a lot. I don't like to be here a lot. It's kind of his world. I want to turn it, I want, this is a fight, right? So a lot of times what I'll do, right off the bat, no higher than his nipples, my hands come right here. Human nature tells him to do what? He wants to grab my hands. Go ahead and just grab my hands, just like that. We've not rehearsed this, but I just know what he's going to do. Human nature tells him to grab my hands, because I could be doing stuff with him, right? He's trying to arm bar me, he's trying to do things, so he's going to grab a hold of my hands. But like I said, they're no higher than his nipple, right there. Now, I put my head down, because I know where his head's at, right? It's right above my hands. I put my head down. Oh, go ahead and hold on to him. How are you? And so here I am. Now, one hand is going to go to his jaw, and the other hand to his hip. Now, with him holding him like this, it's going to be kind of easy. It's not, there's nothing holding on to my hand. So go ahead and just grab him just like that. It doesn't matter how strong he is. I've done this against Brock Lesnar. He's trained with Brock Lesnar. And so here I am. One hand goes to his jaw, the other hand to his hip, and I do it in a violent motion, okay? I'm not up here and I'm not doing this. When I do this, it's violent. I want his head put back to the mat, and I want to know exactly where his jaw is at. Boom. Okay? So right now, he's still got a hold of my hand, and I'm leaning back on my heels and my feet. So now then, I roll this out. There's nothing he can do to keep me from rolling this out. I roll it out, I come on my knees, boom, and I hit. And I reset. Now then, I just do the opposite side. Boom, boom. So I can do this. I've got two different sides I go to, right? Two different sides. If he blocks his head, I go down. And if I go and he blocks his body, I go to the head. It's a very fast and violent movement, very quick. So in real time, I be here. Ooh, it's just great. I'm sorry.
That's fine.
You're good. Okay, so it's a very, very quick movement. I cannot be grandma driving Miss Daisy and think I'm going to be effective at all. This has got to be quick. And the key part is me coming. When I throw this, my effective strike, I come up when I'm on my knees. You see how I'm on my knees now? I've got a lot more power to come down.
That's cool.
Okay? I've heard people say, well, you can get armbarred. There's no way he can armbar me with this quick of a motion. This arm's up there before he even knows it. This hand hits before he's got any type of a reaction. Okay? 10 minutes. That is the most effective strike on the ground I've ever seen, taught, at all. I love it. Awesome. BJ Penn, he beat me. He beat me twice. The first time BJ beat me, he did a very good job. I was on the ground, and he had my feet. Now, what BJ did was he swung me out of the way and came down with a big punch right here. It hit me. That was a very good job. BJ did a great job. I don't mind saying that now, we're friends. But when I'm here, there's a couple of different passes. I do, can you guys back up a little bit? From here, I do a Bo Duke real quick. I come in. You know how Bo Duke slides across the hood of the General Lee? I just do the same thing. Now I've got my underhook, and I'm right here. One more time, here I am. I kind of move them around. I never just stay pausing. Can I come around? You're on top. I want to show one more strike from you. Well, I'm going to show a couple more strikes. When he's down here, I always want to push away with his hand. What's his, if I'm pushing away, what's his natural reaction?
Push back.
Just the way we're tuned. So you see how he's looking at my elbow? Woo. As opposed to not looking at my elbow. I want him to look at my elbow. When I'm pushing away, he's gonna push back at me. Now when I feel that, I'm just doing this so he doesn't, I don't hurt him. When I feel that pressure coming back, what I'll do is I'll slide it off and it hits him. Ooh. It's called a slide elbow. So if I push, your skull, this is very easy to cut up here with an elbow because there's the bone behind it. Down here where your cheek is and your jaw and your all that, it's very hard to cut with an elbow. Boxers can cut the cheek and all that because at the end of a punch they twist. And that, does that make sense?
Yeah.
That's how boxers can cut all this stuff. We as fighters cut most of the time up here because of those elbows. So when I'm here, I push away. If I feel him pushing back, I'll let him push back and throw the elbow. When you throw an elbow, you try and miss because I don't want to bruise him with this part of my elbow. I want to cut him with my knife right there. So if I try and miss, you'll barely skim him, and that's how you cut him. My favorite strike from the ground. I never got to do this. I've got my hand on the back of his head. What's his natural, if I push down, what's his natural reaction?
To come up.
To come up, just the way we are. So now that he can't see what I'm doing, I'm gonna chamber this arm. I pull down. You're fine. I pull down, I can feel him pulling up. When I feel him pulling up, I then pop him with my hips. Make sense? I feel him pull up, I pop him with my hips. Now this hand gauges how far he is away from me. So here I feel him pulling up, I pop him up, and I make these two meet right here. That's a legal elbow in the UFC, okay? But if I hit him up here, I think I'd cut him all the way down to his nose. Okay? One more move I'm going to show you and we're going to be done. Go, go back. Give me just a little bit of space. I need a little more space for you. I don't need any space over here, girls. Come close. Now this is the move that works a lot. Some people will look at this and say it's a clinic move. You know what a clinic move is? Looks good in a clinic, but it'll never last, it'll never happen in real life. I hit this move a lot. It's kind of flashy. My model here is falling down. He's on the mat, right here. I'm standing over the top of him. If I want him to come up to his feet, all I have to do is look at the ref and back away from him, right? When the ref tells him to come up. So, but I want him on the ground. So I had to advance on him. If I go to advance on him, the ref could say stand up. So when I advance on him, I do that with a bending front knee because he's going to be kicking at my knee. So I don't want to have a straight knee and have him kick. So I come in, my hands up, I'm blocking it in, and I've got a bending front knee. Now he's got his foot on right there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come down. I'm just going to, this is what I want right here. I want his feet on the ground, and I've got pressure on his knees. Right there. You see that? Now I'm safe. He can't reach up and strike with his fist, and he's not going to kick me with his legs. So my leg is now so deep, my toes are touching his butt. Okay? My toes are touching his butt, it's that deep. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a backward circular step. Switch hands. See that? This hand comes up, I sit down, come here.
You see this?
Yeah. He says he does.
What's your name?
Josh, and you, what do you do here?
Jiu-Jitsu.
He's a teacher, he's a Jiu-Jitsu and MMA. I looked down, he was kind of getting there, and what's it, have you seen this? Because I do this all the time. So you would say this 80%, 80%, most 80% of the time? I'm glad he does it. So when I'm here, my toes are touching him, I've got pressure on his legs. This leg has to stay down. So I don't keep this leg down, and I try and do this backward circular step. He brings that leg up, I don't have anything now. That's my defense. Right where he's at, And I know that I know this, I bring this leg up. So here I am. Pressure down on this leg. Boom, boom, boom. Now my butt's on his ribs. Okay? So I'm safe. There's nothing he can do to do it. Maybe he can punch my kidneys or my rib. I don't care. What I do is I make a pillow out of his foot. That means he's pushing between my head and the ground. So I come up, I keep this leg in, and here I am. Now, his knee's a little bit too high, which I'd rather be too high. I'll come in, I'll push him down a little bit, and there's my knee bar. I use my elbow there. Now, if I can't put enough pressure on him, I take my high hand, I pull his leg up, I push with my low hand, and I put it right back here. Okay, one more time. Here we are, legs, this leg's gotta stay down. My toes are touching, backwards circular step, boom, boom, boom. Now I'm waiting for the right time, I keep this leg in, I make a pillow on his foot. Here he is. My amoeba. That's my clinic move. And I love it. That move works 90%, 85-90% of the time. He's going to show up from half guard.
See, when I do it in half guard, I start attacking his head. It's misdirection. I start coming here, putting in. Most Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu guys are going to try to shrug from here. So they start shrugging. This is where I go for from here. I sit here and I push this leg back. Put your foot this way.